Effects of space particles and radiation environment on satellites operation in near-Earth space environment. When charged trapped or transient particles from solar events or cosmic sources bombards and interacts with the exposed surfaces of spacecraft, their effects can affect the system in a several ways. The effects from the natural space environment include spacecraft charging, SC, single event effects, Cs, total ionizing dose, TID, and displacement damage, DD. However, the specific effect depends on the type of incident particle, its energy and probably the source. Trapped heavy ions do not have sufficient energy to generate the ionization required to cause Cs, and they do not make a significant contribution to TID. Galactic cosmic rays and cosmic solar particles, which are heavily influenced by solar flares and trapped protons in the radiation belts, can cause Cs, but electrons are not known to cause Cs. Although their physical mechanisms are different, the ionizing radiation of the space environment causes both TID and Cs. Charged particle effects in the space environment are summarized below according to the particle source. Spacecraft charging, SC, is the buildup of charge on spacecraft surfaces or in the spacecraft interior. SC causes variations in the electrostatic potential of a spacecraft surface with respect to the surrounding plasma environment, and potential variations in different portions of the spacecraft. The major natural space environments which contribute to SC include the thermal plasma environment, high energy electrons, solar radiation and magnetic fields. Although SC has many effects, electrostatic discharges appear to be the most dangerous of all. Electrostatic discharges can cause structural damage, degradation of spacecraft components and operational anomalies due to damages to electronics. SC can be categorized into two, surface charging which include differential charging, and internal dielectric charging. Surface charging is caused by low energy plasma, 100 kiloelectronvolts, which penetrate into the spacecraft equipment where they deposit charge inside insulating materials. Internal discharge is more damaging since it occurs within dielectric materials and well-insulated conductors, which are in close proximity to sensitive electronic circuitry. Based on data from the Combined Release and Radiation Effects Satellite, CER, obtained at GEO, most environmentally induced spacecraft anomalies result from deep dielectric charging and the resulting discharge pulses and not from surface insulator charging or single event upsets. Single event effects, Cs, are individual events which occur when a single incident ionizing particle deposits enough energy to cause an effect in a device. Cs are generally caused by two space radiation sources, high-energy protons, and cosmic rays. Single event phenomenon can be classified into 4, I, single event upset, SCU, 2, single event latch up, SEL, 3, single event burnout, SEB, and, 4, single event gate rupture, SEGR. SEU is a change of state caused by ions or electromagnetic radiation striking a sensitive node in a microelectronic device, such as in a microprocessor, semiconductor memory, or power transistors. The state change is a result of the free charge created by ionization in or close to an important node of a logic element, for example, memory bit. The error in device output or operation caused as a result of the strike is called a soft error. The mechanisms for heavy ion and proton SEU in devices, for example, dynamic random access memories, DRAM, and galactic cosmic ray energy deposition in devices are depicted in. SEU can cause a reset or rewriting in normal device such as an analog, digital, or optical components, and may also have effects in surrounding interface circuitry. A severe SEU is the single event functional interrupt, SEFI, in which an SEU in the device's control circuitry places the device into a test mode, halt, or undefined state. The SEFI halts normal operations, and requires a power reset to recover. A. Mechanisms for heavy ion and proton SEU. B. Schematic showing how GCR deposit energy in an electronic device. And C. Upset mechanism for dynamic random access memories, DRAMs, from REF. SEL is used in integrated circuits, ICs, to describe a particular type of short circuit which can occur in an improperly designed circuit. It is the generation of a low impedance path between the power supply rails of a MOSFET circuit that can trigger a parasitic structure which disrupts proper functioning of the part and possibly even leading to its destruction due to overcurrent. SELs are hard errors, and can cause permanent damage. It can result in a high operating current, above device specifications, drag down the bus voltage, or damage the power supply. Latch up can be caused by protons in very sensitive devices. And cell is corrected or cleared by a power off on reset or power strobing of the device. Cell is strongly temperature dependent. If power is not removed quickly, catastrophic failure may occur due to excessive heating or metallization or bond wire failure. SEB is a condition caused by high current state in a power transistor. It is a highly localized phenomenon, and includes burnout of the drain source in power MOSFETs and BJTs, gate rupture, frozen bits, and noise in charged coupled devices, CCDs. SEGR is the formation of a conducting path or localized dielectric breakdown in the gate oxide resulting in a destructive burnout. It occurs at MOSFETs, BJTs, and CMOS. Solar flare particle events pose the most extreme CEU-producing environment, especially for spacecraft in interplanetary space. Experiments aboard Crew showed a significant increase during a solar flare. Based on Crew's data, most CEUs come from high-energy protons through nuclear interactions and not through direct deposition from either protons or cosmic rays. For LEO satellites, trapped protons, especially in the SA, are the greatest CEU threat. Total ionizing dose, TID, refers to the amount of energy that ionization processes create and deposit in materials such as semiconductor or insulator when energized particles pass through it. TID can result in device failure or biological damage to astronauts. Radiation-induced trapped charges can build up in the gate oxide of a MOSFET and cause a shift in the threshold voltage. Such device cannot be turned off even at 0 volts applied, if the shift is large enough. Under this condition, the device is said to have failed by going into depletion mode. TID is mostly due to electrons and protons, mainly from solar energetic particle event and passage through the SA. In low Earth orbit, the main dose source is from electrons and inner belt protons, while the primary source is outer belt electron and solar protons in geostationary orbit. The first recorded satellite failure resulting from total dose was the Telstar. The satellite was launched a day after the Starfish nuclear test on July 9, 1962. The nuclear weapon of about 1.4 megaton was detonated at an altitude of about 400 kilometers above Johnston Island in the Pacific Ocean. The explosion produced beta particles, electrons, that were injected into the Earth's magnetic field, forming an artificial radiation belt. This artificial electron belt lasted until the early 1970s. Consequently, Telstar experienced a total dose 100 times that expected before its total failure. Up to 7 satellites were destroyed by the Starfish nuclear test within 7 months, mainly from solar cell damage. When energetic particles are incident on a solid material, they lose their energy to ionizing and non-ionizing processes as they travel through the material. The consequence of the energy loss is in the production of electron hole pairs and atoms displacement or displacement damage. Vacancies, i.e., absence of an atom from its normal lattice position, and interstitials, i.e., movement of displaced atom into a non-lattice position, are the primary lattice defects that are initially created. The combination of a vacancy and an adjacent interstitial is known as a Frenkel or close pair. Two adjacent vacancies can form a defect known as divacancy. Also, larger local groupings of vacancies may occur in irradiated silicon. A defect resulting from vacancy and interstitials being adjacent to impurity atoms is known as defect impurity complexes. Once formed by incident radiation, the defects will reorder to form more stable configuration. The extent to which defects alter the properties of bulk semiconductor material and devices depends on nature of the particular defects and the time following the creation of defect at a given temperature. The effectiveness of radiation-induced displacement damage depends on factors such as bombardment condition, particle type and energy, irradiation and measurement temperature, time after irradiation, thermal history after irradiation, injection level, material type, impurity type and concentration. Displacement damage causes degradation of materials and device properties. Depicts the collision between an incoming particle and a lattice atom, causing the displacement of the atom from its original lattice position. Displacement damage can also degrade minority carrier lifetime, and a typical effect would be degradation of gain and leakage current in bipolar transistors. Displacement of atom from its original lattice position by incoming particle through collision.